Welcome everybody to Let's Play Megaman X3. I'm your host, that guy, and I've completely forgotten what we're up to. So we just recently beat these two. And I know that this guy is weak to the crawfish ability, which is the whatever blade that was, slicing and dicing blades. Neon Tiger! Wolverine wannabe. Fast forward. Who cares? Hope everyone's doing okay out there. Not much has happened for me today. I was supposed to help my friend at her work, but she didn't actually end up contacting me on when to meet, so I couldn't go. And she ended up going without me, which I guess is good for me because I don't have to work. But I actually prefer to do stuff. Basically to fill in time. I hate being just at home bumming, for lack of better words. So, there we go. Subtank! We need more health. More health? Yes. Oh, thanks. Nah, we don't really need it that badly. Mega Man, good series. Gotta say, I wish they went back to their 2D style gaming, because they have their 3D one, which is Mega Man X7, I believe it is, or 8, I can't remember. Weak to acid? Nope. Oh, this looks like a trap. Sudden drop. Okay, you do get an ability later on which lets you air dash upwards, which is what they're trying to tell me here. So, but to be honest, you could probably finish the game without getting all the upgrades anyway, so it's not a big deal, and there's no way I could really get there. So, I think I need to fight Bite in here. No. Stupid antlion looking at me. Aww. Aww, you're kidding me. Oh well. Can't win them all. Kinda wish it didn't give the that kind of sound effect when it got hit. Ah. It is going faster, in case you haven't noticed. That's not by a significant amount, though, so... Oh. I'm pretty sure there'd be an easier way to do this, but... Using the Mega Buster, I'm used to it. Like, in pretty much all the Mega Man series, using the Mega Buster, X-Buster, is pretty much usually the recommended way to go, unless you actually do know their weakness, but... Because I don't. Yeah, I still haven't activated this thing yet. It's gonna annoy me. What kind of enemy is that? Mario enemy? When I say Mario enemy, I'm just talking about an enemy that their only attack is to try to run into you. Now, they may have spikes in them or something like that, but it's funnier when it's just a standard enemy that you normally see. Like the Goombas, for lack of better words. Is it time to fight Bite? No. We've already beaten Bit, who isn't that hard, but... Of course, seeing that Bite is much larger, I'm sure he'll be a lot more fun to fight against. With all kinds of crazy abilities. But, don't worry, I've actually played this through anyway, so... I know what his attacks are, but, to be honest, I can't even remember how to dodge him anyway, so... What's the point? Can I get up there? Is there anything up there, even? Oh, there probably is something up there. You see a wall like that, you know there's gonna be something there. Come on, can you get it? Go the other way, please? Come on! Get the other way! You're just gonna keep going in that same loop, aren't you? Yeah. Regardless, we're gonna go in that same loop. So, yeah. Yeah, that'll do. Heart tank! We do need more health. I think I've only collected a handful of them throughout the game, so. Yeah. Definitely need to get more. Okay, so his weakness is this thing. I can beat him normally, but using this joystick may not be a good idea. From what I remember, it's easier to get him on the reflection of the attack. Only because the reflect is... I don't remember it doing that sound effect, though. There we go. That's a bit low. Oops. Well. I mean, yeah, I don't really need save states to beat him. I mean, I could have just waited, used sub tanks, but to be honest, I can't be bothered. It's like, I'm starting to feel like I should use them now. That's how we do it. That's right. Wait for him to go up there, and yeah. It's not the first hit that's going to hit you anyway, so don't worry about it. As I always say. Oh. The first hit isn't designed to hit you. It's actually like the second or the third hit. So, it sounds a bit stupid when you think about it. I mean, if you get an attack, wouldn't you try to hit him on the first shot? I guess it could be like, you know, trying to adjust for aiming. And... that's Neon Tiger done. Shuriken. Fast forward everything. You get, yep, that really stupid attack. Raise Washa. Let's keep going. Who's weak to it? I think it's actually Toxic Seahorse that's weak to it, so... crap, now I can't remember who's next. This weapon is strong against this, that's strong against that. So I'm guessing that this one should be next, because I can't remember what his weakness is, but... I guess it's one of the ones I've already got. And this is... Gravity Beetle! I gotta say, any of the enemies that use gravity, I do like them. Like, they're usually good opponents because, is it Mega Man X6 where there's Gravity Antlion or something like that? Wait, Antlion? I don't think it's Antlion, but it does seem to be a Beetle type enemy anyway, so. Okay, what weapon goes through? I'm gonna go with the drill again. It seems like the drill. Nope. Nope. I don't see how that's gonna work, but. Okay. I guess we don't have it yet. Whatever it's supposed to be, we don't have it. Which is fine. Health, as I said, is not that important, because you do get abilities later on, which are like. Let's quick check. You take less damage, and when you get that, you know, significantly easier. Of course, there are alternatives to it, though. Here's Bite. Nice to meet you, X. I am Bite. I have been programmed to exterminate you. Okay, if I remember correctly, that's pretty much his only attack. Oh, oh. So it's a ram, the uppercut into the, that really. I'm doing so little damage right now that it may not be worth it. Let's see if we can just find out what his weakness is. That work well? Let's just weapon test here. because, as I said, I don't know what his weakness is, so... No, that's not it. It is kind of weird that it's a two-hitter. Oh, that's gonna kill me. That's the weakness. Okay. I should have known that, actually. Actually, it's kind of weird because, it's kind of like magnetic when it hits the wall. And from what I hear, you can dodge it quite easily. Alright. There we go. When you think about how many hits it does, though, it's a little excessive. Now I think about it, it is quite hard, actually. No, that's what she said, jokes, please. How can this great power be generated from within such an ancient machine? What an X. The victory is yours. But the battle is far from over. And this is actually destroying Bite, so you can do that to Bit as well, but as I said, I don't think I had his weakness, or unless it just means like destroying him with Robot Master weapons, which makes more sense actually. That's the frog ability. Basically, when you get your right armors, eventually you can change into frog form, which you do need. I gotta admit, there's enemies again. The only reason why they give you some of these abilities is so that you can pick up other items. Like the frog one is hopeless on land. It is absolutely hopeless. There is no point in it whatsoever on land. So, you know, if you do get it, choose Hawk, which is the H power up. How many subtanks do we get? Oh, just going for our second one. Oh, I guess we did only pick the last one up last stage, so... I'm actually going to need the one-ups now, because in case I do decide to do a suicide before the boss, I need to be ready. And at least have more lives. If this is going to be a crappy mini-boss... Nope, not a crappy mini-boss. Oh, come on, like, that isn't obvious. Oh, but I can't use it anyway. Now, I always found it amusing that they always choose to start... If the place is going to collapse, it'll start with the area closest to you. Like... Why not start from the side that you're heading towards? Wouldn't that make more sense? Probably. That's probably when it didn't order as well. Yeah, I still don't have the weapon to go through that. It's the exact same as it was before. I feel sorry for some of these enemies, they can't even attack you properly. Like, they have to do indirect fire. Like, I don't know, if you could see the enemy, I think that the game would be a lot easier. I mean, targeting with them would be a lot easier. I mean, yeah, I have played, what is it? Battlefield 1942? And, there is the ability to, oh, look at the damage on that. It even goes through his overdrive attack. Now that's just disturbing. Like, yeah, I know you're a boss, but, okay, I'll just show you his attacks anyway. He throws this little ball around and it reflects off all walls. That's all it is. He does have a super one of it, which I've probably pissed him off enough to do now. Yeah, there we go. And basically, just don't touch the hole. And that's all there is to it. He's, yeah, it is interesting if you find him with just the X-Buster, because, yeah, it's significantly more difficult, obviously, but I guess all the bosses are if you just use, normal tactics. Gravity Well, okay, against smaller enemies it works, but against some of the huge enemies, yeah, don't bother. Not gonna work. We got enough time for one more, actually. And I know that Hornet Boy here is actually weak against me. Or is it? Did they call him by his other name? Yeah, blast one. Okay. Yeah, his video clip's not that bad, actually. It shows him, like, reproducing, but... because, you know, bees, they just have lay eggs and stuff like that. Lava. So, yeah, it's not bad. Got another one of these really stupid looking elevators. Indirect fire again! See, I'm actually jumping up and pressing dash while holding up, and that should allow you to do your dash jump, but obviously, I can't seem to do it. That looks a bit... I think I need the ability again. Let's get through there. Something tells me I'm supposed to keep going up. Crap, where'd I load? Yeah, that's okay. Okay, I know what's up there now. That's actually the Hawk... well, not the Hawk armor, but a Ride armor stand. So you use the Hawk armor, you dash, jump all the way up to there. And that's pretty much it. And it'll give you an item, but I can't remember what it was. Can't move. Ah, this enemy. Couldn't even be bothered to color him in, probably. From what I remember, this is the easy way to beat him. And then when he goes into this mode, just jump over him. So basically the idea is attack him when it's heading towards you, and yeah, that's it pretty much. Not a particularly difficult boss. I gotta admit, I used to just pound them with bullets all the way through, because just tapping the shoot button like a billion times also works. Just so you know, I don't actually know what a boss's weakness is, because mid-bosses have weaknesses as well, but for the life of me, I can't remember what it is. And why are we going this way when there could be stuff down there? No, there's nothing down there. Never mind. Yeah, it's a rather hot day today. I got my friend a Galileo thermometer, which is quite happy with, actually. I was surprised with how happy she was about it, actually. I was expecting her to be like, you know, what the heck is this thing? It turned out she knew what it was, so, yeah, I'm pretty surprised by that. Okay, I believe this is supposed to signify that you can now use right armors. So from this point on in the game, whenever we come across a right armor platform, we can now use them. Which means we can start backtracking. Ugh, probably the worst part of gaming in general. When you know, like, yeah, we've done the stage, but we gotta do it again. One good thing, though, is I'm pretty sure that while you're in right armors, hey. Nice attempt at tricking me. Well, for a heart container, which is all worth it. Overhanging ledges, like, that's definitely gonna be a giveaway. Like, you know, as soon as you see one, you're gonna be like, yeah, that's something I gotta do. This is a bit and bite chamber. It seems like they really want you to go for these chambers. Like, they could have at least, like, just removed the room altogether. I don't know how hard that would be, though, to be honest. In, programming-wise. It probably is really hard, when I think about it. I'm probably asking for too much. It's like, oh, you could just remove that. Yeah, you want to try making it? No, not really. Now I think about it, it actually does sound quite difficult. Oh. I just want to fill my sub tanks without having to backtrack and do stages, but I guess I just could do Tunnel Rhino stage and yeah. Okay, Gravity Well is the weapon here. This is like one of the easiest bosses, because he can't do anything about it for some reason. And then when you have the upgraded version, it's even funnier. Because you do even more damage. idea is, shoot it, basically gravity ruins him. And that's all there is to it, you just keep shooting it. He literally won't do anything about it. I don't think he can do anything about it now, I think about it even. Look, it's not even near him. Like, I'll try to get on close to him, but I'm pretty sure I won't be able to. Just make sure you don't shoot one outside the screen. When you press the fire button, it automatically deploys, so that isn't me pressing shoot again or anything. I'm actually just mashing shoot. And that's it. Last one, it's done. Fast forward! Sure again. Okay, we didn't even get to show his attack. Basically, that latches onto an enemy, and then they blow up. So, one person left. I'm going to end this video here, though, because that's 20 minutes, and I want to do all the backtracking with the next video anyway. So, yeah, I'll leave you guys to it. Take care of yourselves out there, yeah?